What parts of these last two wins for you guys do you think you can take in, as the you know the competition ramps up, San Antonio comes in next game? What parts do you think are sustainable?
Just keep playing defense, like I said before, you know, after the game. As long as we play defense, you know, we give ourselves the best chance and gives us opportunities to get on the break. That's when we're at our best.
You know, were there things you noticed when you were out with the shoulder watching that you think you've been able to apply any differently in these last two games compared to how you started the season?
I mean, we just had to get our fight back. You know, looking at it, looked like we was getting down a little bit. So I just had to bring the energy back, and I feel like we're doing that now.
There's one play I didn't ask you about on the court where it looks like you kind of throw it back to Julius and ended up kind of going in. Do you view plays like that as just a chance to get guys going, a chance to get the excitement and along those lines?
It's just how I play, kind of wild, kind of free. I'm glad he made it because I saw Luke going to the bench. You know, he didn't make it, so I don't know how he caught it, but it went in.
Well, you did have 25 turnovers as a team, but I think you only had one. So what part of that do you think that you focused on in terms of the mistakes that were getting out of hand, but you managed to avoid that?
Turnover has been a big thing for us, you know, especially in the losing we've been doing. So just try to make that a focus for me, especially being point guard. You know, I got the ball in my hands a lot of the time. So just try to set a good example by taking control of the ball.
Look, if there was one play where you're, you know, having feeling your shoulder a little bit. Is it something you just have to keep learning and how to play with? Is it going to get sore once in a while?
Yeah, just got to play through it. You know, we call them stingers. You know, I get them from time to time, and I got one today.
Feel okay now?
Yeah, just got to put some ice on it, and you know, should be ready to go.
Did Luke say something to you eventually about that assist to Julius?
We got 2 points, so we just left it at that. Kept playing.
Lonzo, you struggled from the field a little tonight, but you still got a quad five. And you're plus 33 while you're in the court. What's the mentality like for a game like this for you?
I'm going to just go out there and play. You know, my game's not all scoring. You know, whether I score or not, I feel like I still impact the game, you know, multiple ways, and that's what I did tonight.
Lonzo, a lot gets made out of you playing De'Aaron Fox. What did you see out of him tonight?
You know, you can see he's getting his confidence. You know, he's shooting the ball well. You know, he's unbelievable in transition. So, you know, I wish him the best moving forward. I know he's going to, you know, be great.
What was the locker room like after this one?
I mean, it was cool. You know, everybody likes when you win. That's two in a row. Hopefully, we can build on two.
So having Julius in the starting lineup, just what does that do to the starting unit for you?
Gives a little bit more strength, a lot of inside help, and then he's still versatile. You know, offense and he can push the ball, go coast to coast, and he has great screens as well.
Lazo, you've been hitting a lot more threes these last several weeks. Are teams starting to adjust to that at all on the screens, or are you seeing them still play the same way?
Not really. They're still playing the same way. You know, just going to keep shooting.
Speaking of three-pointers, what was it like having like a 7-foot Steph Curry and Brooke Lopez? I mean, he was on.
That's the Brooke we see in practice. So I wasn't surprised. I'm glad he, you know, found a rhythm tonight. And anytime he can do that, it's going to help us a lot.
So you only had one turnover, but the 26 turnovers by the team, is that a concern? And how do you fix that?
Just got to be smarter. You know, I haven't seen the tape, but being on the court, it looked like a lot of dumb stuff was happening, especially on fast breaks. You know, 4-on-1s, 3-on-1s, just making careless passes. So doing that can eliminate probably like 10 of them.
A team like the Kings, you're going to see a lot this year. Does it help getting to see them a second time and kind of know their trends a little bit more?
I mean, it's nice to play. You know, after you've played them the first time, you know them a little bit more. But we got to play everybody the same. You know, we got to come out, play together, and just put our fight up.
And Lonzo, how does this team bounce back so quickly when Brandon is so hot in the beginning but then gets into early foul trouble?
We have a lot of guys on this team, you know, that can step up. So, I mean, Brandon's obviously a big part of it, but, you know, whenever he gets in foul trouble like that, we have other guys step up.